If you are wondering if you can generate barcodes in .NET MAUI, then wonder no more. In this video, we're going to learn how to generate barcodes with the ZXing plugin. In a previous video, which I highly recommend you watch as well, we've seen how to scan barcodes. So that's basically open up your camera, point your camera to that barcode, QR code, EAN, one-dimensional, two-dimensional, can be any barcode, and just scan it with your .NET MAUI application. Now, we're going to look at kind of like the inverse thing where we're going to generate barcodes. So maybe you have this little piece of data that you want to show to a user. Maybe you have some kind of link generator, I don't know. Generate a QR code from that. Let someone else point their camera at your QR code on the screen and they can navigate from there. So we're going to learn how to how easy it is basically to implement generating barcodes in your .NET MAUI application. And it is the exact same package that we've seen in the other video, which I highly recommend you watch, about scanning the barcodes. So it should be really easy to get started with this. Let's check it out. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022. I just whipped up a .NET MAUI application, just a project file new in Visual Studio. I didn't change a thing. This is just a file new template. I did one thing. I installed the NuGet package already. So let's go over to our Solution Explorer and right click here on the project, Manage NuGet Packages. And here under Browse, you want to look for zxing.net.maui. That's the one that you're after. It should pop up here. It's a pre-release at the time of recording. So make sure that you get the latest version and check that include pre-release checkbox here so that it shows up. This version is the latest at the time of recording. If you're watching this, it might be a newer one already. Just take the latest one, that should work. With that installed, there is one other thing that we need to do. Go over to the Solution Explorer again and open your MAUIprogram.cs. And inside of there, you want to use your generic host builder, and right behind your Use MAUI app, or doesn't really, the order doesn't really matter, you want to add the Use Barcode Reader. Now, mind you, it says Barcode Reader, but you also need it for the generation. So maybe, because this is still a preview, maybe the John who is creating this plugin will decide like, no, this is not the right name. I'm going to change it a little bit. So beware if this changed, but for now it's Use Barcode Reader. Also the green squigglies in here is something that needs to be fixed on the library side. So don't worry about that for now. Okay, we got that. If it doesn't add the using here at the top automatically, using zxing.net.maui, make sure that you add it for, you know, using Barcode Reader right here. So now that we got that in place, it's actually time to use the barcode generation. And to do that, I like to do it in XAML. You can totally do it in C# code if that's what you want as well. We want to add this little XML NS here first. And I want to name this ZXing. So this can be any name, but ZXing seems to make sense. So I'm going to add that. And whenever you type then here, the IntelliSense is going to help us. And you're going to have to look for zxing.net.maui.controls. That is the namespace where all the controls live. So let me just get that in here. And I'm going to replace this image with our actual barcode. So ZXing, I can type that now as our XML namespace. We have the barcode generator view. That's the one we're going to see here. And the camera barcode reader view, which is what you can see in the other video. And a generic camera view, we're not going to worry about that for now. So let's get this barcode generator view. And this only has a couple of properties basically, which is the format. So here you can specify the format that you want to generate, which supports a lot. Aztec, code 39, code 93, EAN 13. I haven't even heard of most of these. And here you have the QR code. So let's just start with that one. And you can specify a value. So with this value, for a QR code, it can be anything. So I don't know, let's do something crazy like please subscribe. Maybe you have a favorite channel with a favorite YouTuber who tells you about your favorite .NET MAUI content that you want to subscribe to. Do it now. So please subscribe to my channel. Let's just put that in here. Doesn't really matter. And for styling, you can do some other things. You can say background color, you can specify a background color that you want, or maybe more interesting is a foreground color. Let's just make it, I don't know, red, so it will show up nice and red. And this is basically all that you can do. Well, probably it's nice to also specify a width and a height so that we, you know, don't make it full screen or whatever it's going to do by default. So let's make this 200 and 200. Actually, while checking this and running it on Windows there seems to be a little bug right now where it will just check the full height. So you probably want to, I don't know, put that in some kind of layout and kind of like size the image accordingly. It will probably be fixed with a next release. But for now, on Android, we're just going to see this QR code. It should show up 200 by 200. And we have this nice, pretty QR code. And I'll wait here for a second. Just whip out your phone, get that QR code scanner in here, and you will see that the value is please subscribe now inside of this QR code. So that's basically how easy it is to generate QR codes with this package. One little note before I let you go. If you are going to do EAN13, or probably it's true for some other formats as well, then you want to make sure that the values actually line up. So what you want to do is here, format. So we have EAN13. I think it's going to give you some runtime exception as well. So you want to do 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, which is like 10 characters, right? But it's EAN13. So I think it will say something like, hey, I got 10 characters now, but I expect 12 or 13 if there's some kind of checksum character in there. So you want to make sure that you have the good amount of characters in here, because else there will be some validation thing and it will throw you an exception. And that is how you generate barcodes in .NET Maui. Well, short and sweet video. It's just, you know, install the NuGet package, add it in the initialization line, and you can start generating barcodes. Now, of course, the properties that you've seen here are all bindable, so you can have dynamic values put in here and generate all kinds of QR codes and all kinds of other formats of barcodes in here inside of your app. This works for Android, iOS, macOS, and Windows. It is still a preview package. There might be a couple of bugs, but we'll figure it out. Please report them on the plugin repository so that we can start working on fixing them. Thank you so much for watching again one of my videos. Please click the like button if you've actually liked this video so that it will spread out to more people throughout the YouTube universe. And if you're wondering about more .NET Maui content, check out this playlist right here for more .NET Maui content. If you're still looking for that video on scanning barcodes, that's right here. And click this button to make sure that you're subscribed, and I'll be seeing you for the next video.